Welcome to the new video in Microsoft Excel. There are many new functions which has been added in the recent version of Excel, in especially Microsoft Excel Office 365 and also 2021. There are plenty of functions, but one of my favorite function is which I'll be covering in this video. The name of the function is sequence. Sequence is a function which is very, very useful. And let me tell you the uses of that. So this video will cover 11 examples of sequence function. Let me tell you what exactly is that. Suppose if I have to type some number 1, 2 and 3, and if I want to see those numbers till 1000, what is the traditional method we do? We just select 2 and 3 and then drag down using small dot symbol, also known as fill handle, and I can drag down till I get the number as 1000. It's a lengthy process. That is one of the method. But now the recent version of Microsoft Excel has added a feature of sequence. You don't have to select and drag down. Instead of that, you can just type as equal to sequence. You can type as 1000 over here. The moment you type 1000, close the bracket. What it will do is, when I press enter over here, it will create all the numbers till 1000 over here. And I don't have to use any drag and fill option. Now, to do this activity, there are many different examples, but this is very, very useful. The first example is creating a numbers till 1000. So same way, if I want to create numbers till 10, so I can just type here as equal to sequence and 10 and press enter. This will create numbers till 10. Now, similarly, now let's understand what exactly is the sequence function. When I type here sequence, if you see the parameters, it says rows, columns, start and step. Rows is a function or a parameter which is mandatory. You have to use that particular parameter here. The columns, if you see, it's in the square bracket, start, step. These are all in the square bracket. That means these are some optional, which you don't have to use it. Now, suppose if I want this 10 rows, comma, one column, and I can close the bracket, still I'll be getting the same answer. That means 10 records and only one row. I can press F2 from my keyboard, remove this part, and I can say that start from number one, comma, and step one. That means increment by one. So when I press enter, I'll be getting the same answer over here. So now remember, when I press F2 from here, suppose I want this 10 rows, which is given over here, 10 rows and one column, comma. If I want to start the numbers from, let's say, 5, comma 1. So it will start the numbers from 5, increment by 1. And if I press enter, you can see 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 till 14. So if you count these numbers, these are total 10 numbers over here. That's the next example. Now suppose if I want to see 10 rows and 2 columns, so I can type here sequence 10 rows, comma 2 columns, close the bracket. So by default, it will give me starting number from 1. When I press enter, you can see these are 10 rows and 2 columns. Let me press F2. So if I say that I want the numbering to start from, let's say 10, comma, and increment should be done by, let's say 2. So what will happen is when I close the bracket, press enter. So this will give me 10 rows, 2 columns, starting from number 10 and increment by 2. When I press enter, you can see 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 16, 18, and so on. So this gives me 10 rows and 2 columns. On the other hand, if I want to see only 10 rows and 2 columns, how do I do that? So let's try that. Here I can type as equal to sequence. I can type here, let's say 2 rows, comma 10 columns, and I can press enter. So this will give me the number in the horizontal format. So 1 to 10, these are 10 columns, whereas 2 records will be given. The next example I have, suppose I want to start this number. So I can put here comma 100. So numbering will start from 100 and by default, it will increment by 1. So you see 100, 101, 102 and so on. Whereas if I want to see comma, if I say 10, this will increment by 10. So it will give me 100, 110, 120, 130 and so on. I also have a feature to go in the negative format. So I can say minus 10. So if I say minus 10, 100 minus 10, then 90 minus 10, 80 minus 10, and you can see those are the numbers I'll be getting. Now, let's see the next part. So if I want to have only one row and 10 columns, it would be very easy now. So I can write here as equal to sequence, and I can press tab key, one row, comma 10 columns, and then enter. This will give me the answer here. Let's see some more examples. Now, if I want three rows and three columns, equal to sequence, and I'll write as three rows, three columns, enter. This will give me all the numbers. Now, this is one example, but what if I want to actually use it for some date functions? How do I use it? Let's try in the other sheet. Here, let me increase the size. Now, suppose if I want the date in a sequence, usually what we do is we just write the date 1/1/2024, enter. Now, if I use this drag and fill option till number 10, I'll be getting all the numbers incremented by 1. If you see 1/1/2024, 1/2/2024. So if I keep on going down, it is in the format of MMDDYYY. Now let's try for the weekdays. So if I write here 1/1/2024, and if I press Control Enter, now if I drag down, carefully observe, I've got all the dates. Now suppose if I want to only have the weekdays, so I can just select this option as weekdays, and carefully observe, after 5th, I did not get 6th and 7th, directly 8th. Same way, after 12th, I did not get 13th and 14th because these are weekends, Saturday, Sunday, and I've got the data. Now, this can be used by the HR, admin, or any person to create a proper calendar over here where they're working and these are the working days in the year. Similarly, if I want, I can also select fill months. When I select fill months, this will give me only months. So it's a MMDDYY format, that's a months over here. And same way, fill years, this will increment by years. Now, there's alternate method of doing the same thing using sequence. Here I can type as sequence and press tab key. In the rows, I can put here the date format, which is given here, let's say 10 rows, and I can put here one column and start from date. So I can write here a date, let's say 1/2024, 1, 1, close the bracket, enter. Now this will give me the dates and the number, which I have to convert into a proper date format. So I'll select the option here. Now if you observe here, the dates have incremented by 1. It's not incremented by 2, it's only by 1. Why? Because by default, if I'm not giving the fourth parameter, it will increment by 1. If I say increment by 3, and if I press enter, carefully observe, after 1st of January, it has given me 4th of January, 7th, 10th, 13th, and so on. Now, same way, suppose if I want to increment the dates by months, which I can say by 1 month minimum, how do I do that? The method would be equal to date format. Here I can write as 2024, and instead of typing a month, I can just write as sequence. So I can put a function inside the other function. Here I can mention as 13, 1. Or even if I put here 13 will work, and the day I can put here 1, enter. So carefully observe, it has converted into a number format. I'll convert into a date format. Now this is what in a incremented by month right now. So January 1st, February 1st, March 1st, April 1st, and so on. So now if I want to increment this by months, how do I do that? Here in the sequence part, I can write as (1, 1, 3). So when I press enter, if you observe, the number of months are incremented by 3. So it comes as first as January, then comes the April, and then the other months here. Now, similarly, if I want to increment by years, I can put here as date. I can put here sequence. Instead of year, I'm putting a sequence, let's say as 10 years, month I'll put 1 and the day as 1, enter. Now, this is what I've got all the data based on the years. Let me just change the date format. Now, here the dates are given as 1901, 1902, 1903, and so on. So right now, if I don't want this from 1901, I can put here (1, from 2000 year onwards, you just increment by 1, enter. Now, this is how I've got 2000, 2001, and so on. Suppose if you want the dates by 2010, so I can put here 2010, enter, and I've got the dates here. So, sequence is a function which can be used in multiple directions, multiple usage. Now, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Sequence function can be used or nested inside 200 functions of Excel. So, this is just a start. I want you to try out and find out new features about Microsoft Excel. This is just a beginning. I hope you've understood. That's all for this video.